The HRM Storm, Wednesday, October 11, 2001. Public document. Halifax Regional Municipality. Dear citizens, this is concerning the demise of a small business in your neighborhood named Silver Spoon Trading, formerly located at the back of 336 Prince Albert Road on Braemar Drive. In February of year 2000, in this former city of Dartmouth, I found a beautiful spot to open a small legally registered personalized Silver Spoon Trading store. A buy, sell, and exporting business. In this location I realized a beautiful feeling of being at home in a close-knit neighborhood full of friends and good people. It had a street that was quiet, quaint, filled with history, and many beautiful trees. I found the perfect place to invest my future in. So my partner and I decided to commence the building of our small business. And so I started on my dream to own a small business. I hoped this would be a rags-to-riches story. I paid the rent and commenced on the clean-up, renovating, and stocking of my store. I spent the next 2 months working in a frozen building with no heat, no electrical system, frozen pipes with no water, no insulation, no interior walls. Let me put it this way. The place was a dump. As my landlord Mr. Nabi Talani had just bought this only a few days before I occupied it, from an HRM tax cell. He had had no time afforded to him to do any repairs. Now 2 months later, as I approached the completion of the interior of my store, the weather began to warm up. I thought I could start on the exterior of my building's improvements with the warmth from the bright beautiful sun. But then a big bad black storm cloud moved over my beautiful quaint little street. Named HRM, Halifax Regional Municipality. I was never warned or advised by anyone at HRM of this big black imposing storm cloud coming, which then blew down the beautiful Keddies Inn with the swoop of a bureaucrat's pen. The clouds of demolition plaster dust came into my store and covered my clean, freshly painted and stocked store with plaster dust. This rendered my stock unsellable. The storm continued to thunder as the huge destruction machines crashed and thundered for the next month and a half. The noise was unbearable. The dust was unbelievable. It blanketed the whole neighborhood in a white film. As I observed all of this, immediately in front of my business, across the narrow street, it appeared there must have been a tornado in the storm. With no rain in sight to wash everything clean, I then asked everyone, "What is happening? What is going to happen?" A good neighbor told me that a new neighbor is moving in on the street. Well, I always believed that in any neighborhood, when a neighbor wants to do any renovations, construction, erect a fence, or anything else that will affect the neighborhood, that it is city council's job to advise, mediate, protect, inform, or even permit anything. Also to communicate with all the possibly affected parties, neighbors, property owners, and even small business owners that will be affected. I was never consulted or advised of anything at any time from anyone from HRM. Even after I repeatedly asked for information, HRM chose to ignore the fact that my business was here. That makes HRM liable for all damages to my business. Ah, but the storm created by HRM was not over. The storm continued to blow from the bureaucrats. The wind was so strong that it was now turning my clean clothes to rags. As the weather dried up the mud, the dust storms grew even bigger. Everything was covered in a brown dust now. Ever imagined being in a desert sandstorm? That is what it was like every day. The inside of my vehicles were no protection from the storm. They were also, like my customers' vehicles, filled with dust. All my customers ran away for shelter from the storm, never to return. Well, the HRM storm grew even stronger. The winds were so strong that the road and my parking lot were completely blown away, which had been there for over 100 years for everyone to use. I was now blown hard against the wall of my store. Then all of a sudden, without any warning from HRM, the neighbors were given permission to erect a fence right across the public street in front of my store. I now realized that my rags-to-riches story was now being reversed by the HRM storm. But I did not give up hope of surviving this storm. I continued trying to succeed. As I was given no other choice, again I was never informed of anything by HRM. I was completely fenced in from the world. The storm now grew much, much stronger. As the huge thundering earth movers moved in for the next 3 months to remove and replace acres of contaminated soil from an old chemical dump site that had been buried under Keddie's building site, I was now very weakened by the HRM storm. So I tried to stand against the storm and hoped that someone could come to my aid. I covered the fence with rags to symbolize the beginning of the end of my rags-to-riches dreams. Now I was having nightmares of riches to rags. Oh. The storm was so strong that you may have seen this on global news or on the front pages of the daily news, even blew all my rags away. I was now physically, emotionally, and financially drained from my fight with the storm. I did not have the strength to stay in the storm. I tried very hard to keep my head up in the winds of the storm. Every day my eyes and ears were hurting from being exposed to the never-ending ravaging dust storms with the thundering noise. I was the only one left in the dust. All my customers had long run away. Even the neighbors ran for the hills. Like in any horrible storm, the rebuilding had to start. Again, by permit of the Almighty above, HRM, they act like they are gods. But the road or parking lot was not replaced. Instead, I found that HRM told the neighbors that, if they wanted to build, that HRM required that they have to assume the roadway and my parking lot. The Superstars Vice President Jim Stevenson advised me that they did not at any time have any plans of taking over the street, nor did they want it, but that the HRM made it mandatory if the Superstore was to get the building permits from the HRM. HRM refused to upgrade the street to provide the services that the Superstore needed. So because of this, I had to pay a huge cost for the HRM storm, as my financial losses were the HRM's gain. In any devastating storm that I have ever heard of, the costs of reconstruction are always shared by all, not just one lonely little business. This whole construction project was permitted by HRM. I do not believe that there are any laws that have ever been written which allows for any democratically elected parties to have the right to do harm to anyone. It appears that there is a letter missing in the HRM, harm. So I say that it is only fair that HRM refunds my losses. You did not have the right to take my livelihood away. On a personal note, I do not wish the destruction of any storm on anyone, And so, on October 2, in the year of 2000, the little business known as Silver Spoon Trading Storm, like a young small child playing on that wind-blown stormy street, I did not have enough way to stand against the strong winds of the HRM storm. I was blown away and never had a chance to grow up, to learn from my mistakes, to mature. Therefore, could never realize my dreams of owning a small business in what I thought was a beautiful city. It is a shame that our citizens have to live with the threats of the ever-imposing HRM storm. I pray that this storm does not come to your neighborhood. Since the construction of the superstore lasted for a whole year, there is much more that went on that I have not written here. I have many witnesses ready to testify. It is not hard for me to get evidence of the destruction of my business. From the result of decisions made by HRM. Sincerely, Mr. Daniel Towsey, Silver Spoon Trading Store Owner. Revised by Mr. Daniel Towsey on July 14, 2001.